Is your food unnaturally delicious? Well, one ag scientist says it is, and you should be thankful for it. In his new book, Unnaturally Delicious, Jayson Lusk says science and technology are serving up superfoods to save the world. And I sat down with him in studio shortly before the book's release. Jayson, why did you decide to write Unnaturally Delicious?
You know, there's a lot of pessimism, I think, about food in this country. And we do have some serious food problems. There's no denying that. But I think a big issue is, how are we going to solve these problems? And so much of what I read in the news and in popular culture seems to suggest that the way to solve our big food problems is to become all natural again, to sort of turn our clocks back, do things the way our grandparents did. And I think that just is at odds with the historic reality of the way food has evolved. And all the many things we enjoy about our food system today, in large part, have come about because we humans have decided to change our foods and our food system. And so in this book, I try to take a much more positive and forward-looking view about the future of food. And I interview entrepreneurs, I interview scientists and innovators who are doing really interesting and great things that's going to lead to a much brighter food future.
Before we talk about that future, I do want to ask you, if we did turn back the clock, is that even sustainable? Could we feed ourselves?
You know, we humans as a species, we've long passed the point where we could sustain the current population we have eating naturally. We might be able to feed maybe 4 billion people if we went to even the best organic methods and we all converted to vegetarian diets, but we have 7 billion people living on this earth now, and we're probably going to get another billion people in the next 20 years. And so how are we going to feed all these people? Well, we need innovation. We need entrepreneurship to address those challenges. And the good story is that we've been able to do that for centuries. People have been worried about whether we're going to keep up with population growth, and we've been able to do it. And the way we've been able to do it is through science, through innovation, through new technologies, tinkering around with new things, seeing what's going to work. And I'm very optimistic about that future. And I think we're going to meet the challenges, not just to be able to feed that growing world, but to provide better food and more nutritious food and safer food.
Mm-hmm. What are some of your favorite stories out of Unnaturally Delicious?
There's many great stories in the book. And one of the great things for me in writing the book is I got to learn a lot about a lot of the great things going on. A good story, for example, is one of David Waits. He was a former farmer who turned entrepreneur, and he has created software that's now used on over 100 million farm acres worldwide. This is software that's helping farmers farm more precisely, helping them to get higher yields and to make sure that they don't have nutrient runoff that is entering our waterways and causing these sorts of problems. This is an innovation of information technology and big data and internet technologies. And here's a person from Oklahoma that has been able to capitalize on that technology and really put some tools in the hands of farmers to help food security, but also environmental outcomes.
Now, you have a fairly long list of success stories in the book. Why do you think people have not taken notice of them before?
Well, I think they're in our daily lives, we just often don't notice them very much. So just the next time in your kitchen, look around. So you have a microwave, you have a refrigerator, you have a stovetop, you have a mixer. All these things are unnatural human inventions that made our lives easier, better, cooking easier. I've got examples in there of even new kitchen technologies, whether it's 3D food printers, mm-hmm. or even robotic kitchens that mm-hmm. Might help us cook dinner while we get to entertain our dinner guests. Mm-hmm. All these things, I think, you know, they come along gradually, so sometimes we don't notice them, and we sort of forget. We take it for granted, the things that technologies have done for us in our lives.
So, Jayson, you're a researcher. Why do you think that so many people have these negative impressions on our food system?
Part of it's just our human nature and the fact that bad news sells. So we tend to pay more attention to the bad than the good, and unfortunately, it can be quite profitable to scare people and to sell diets and to sell books that uncover so-called secrets about the food system. And I think people tend to see authors and even, you call them food entrepreneurs, if you will, offering all kinds of new things. They think, well, these people are interested in my health and my safety. But the reality is they're often, in many cases, preying on people's fears and profiting on those fears as well. And so, yeah, it's just human nature in a lot of cases, but there's also people that can exploit that human nature to their own gain.
So I guess a final question, where do you think food technology is going to? What are we going to see in the coming years?
I think we'll see all kinds of interesting applications on the farm. We'll see a lot more precision ag technologies. So farmers being much more judicious with their use of fertilizers and herbicides, for example. I think we'll see new crop varieties that are disease resistant, that will provide benefits to consumers, either in terms of improved health or improved safety. On the safety front, I think we'll see, in the book I talk about new food safety technologies so that we can make sure we don't have Chipotle recalls anymore, for example. Those, we need technologies to help us solve those things. So in general, I think we'll see a better food system, a food system that's more sustainable and more affordable.
Now, Unnaturally Delicious is published by St. Martin's Press and is available online and in bookstores.